Residents in Benton Harbor, Michigan, a predominantly black city in the southwestern corner of the state, have been advised to use only bottled water for things like cooking and bathing due to lead contamination. The warning comes just a few years after the water crisis in Flint, Michigan was discovered. And as John Yang reports, Benton Harbor has been detecting elevated levels of lead in its water supply for years.
Judy, today Michigan Governor Gretchen Whitmer signed an executive directive pledging all available state resources to address this issue as quickly as possible. The Lieutenant Governor, Garland Gilchrist, made the announcement in Benton Harbor.
Every person in the state of Michigan deserves access to clean and safe drinking water, and every community deserves lead-free pipes. So we are committed to doing everything that we can to ensure that every parent in Benton Harbor can give their child a glass of water with confidence.
Gilchrist said the state would replace all the city's lead pipes within 18 months, and until that's done, the state will deliver 20 truckloads of bottled water every week. According to state health data, high levels of lead were first detected in the city's drinking water in 2018, and every year since, the level of lead has only gone up. The Reverend Edward Pickney is head of the Benton Harbor Community Water Council, a local environmental justice group. Reverend Pickney, thanks so much for joining us. You have been calling for this emergency directive for a while now, and for a while now, you have been on your own organizing water delivery, organizing filters delivered to homes. How satisfied are you with what the state, what the Lieutenant Governor said today?
Well, you know, I'm happy to hear that they have started to move forward. I'm happy to make sure that they're going to do what they said they're going to do. But one of the things that, to me, they fell a little short. One of the most important thing is the language. The governor needs to say that the water is unsafe to drink, unsafe to brush your teeth, unsafe to cook with, unsafe to bathe with, unsafe to provide baby formula. She used the word abundantly caution. That is not the language we need. I appreciate what she's saying. Don't get me wrong. I appreciate the bottled water and everything, but the language is important. We have to let the people know that it's unsafe to use this water.
What do you hear from people in the community when you move around? Are they anxious? Are they worried? Are they concerned? What are you hearing?
Well, they're very concerned about the mayor not mentioning that the water was contaminated with lead. For 3 years, they concealed this information. They should have told the people that the water was contaminated, but they failed to do so. And that have led the community not to trust not only the mayor, but also the governor. She said she's going to do these things, but we want to see some action, some real action.
The governor pledged some money today. Is the state spending enough on this problem?
Oh, absolutely not. We need at least $35 to $40 million to complete this mission. I think that she should consider, if she's going to finish it in 18 months, she needs to find more money to complete this mission. The transformation of the pipes need to be done now, and she needs to figure out how she's going to pay for it. And don't allow the citizens of Benton Harbor to have to pay for it. That's the way it should be done.
And 18 months is a very ambitious target. They're still trying to finish up the work in Flint.
Yes, absolutely. But remember, in Newark, New Jersey, they completed 20,000 pipelines, you know, and they did that in 18 months. So we only got 6,000. And I think that if they're being aggressive, they can complete it in maybe 12 to 18 months.
This is not a new issue in Michigan. Flint has had this issue. Both Flint and Benton Harbor, the populations are majority black. Both you have a high proportion of people living in poverty. Do you think that's a coincidence?
No. What you just said is a fact. And let me say this. If there was a white person with a baby talking about lead in the water, they would call the Pentagon, they would call FEMA, they would call everybody out there, the Army, everything, to make sure they get rid of all the lead in the water. But being a black community, they have different thoughts about that. Because why would it take 3 years for the governor to even answer, you see?
And given the fact that this has been going on the other side of the state, your Benton Harbor is on the western edge of the state on Lake Michigan. Given that this has been going on Flint, on the eastern side of the state, for a number of years, do you think that the state officials should have been a little more aggressive about this, reacted a little faster?
Absolutely. See, there's no excuse for this. You know, we applaud her for what she's doing now. But she should have did this 3 years ago. You know, we don't know how many children this has affected. Lead is a slow killer. What it does, it destroys the body. Kidney disease, liver disease, brain disease, heart failure, all these things, lead is contribute to that. So we don't know how much damage has been done already. We might even lose a whole generation because of this lead and what it does to the brain. So I'm very, very concerned. And I won't say it's too late, but better late than never, but she should have done it 3 years ago.
The Reverend Edward Pinckney of the Benton Harbor Community Water Council. Thank you very much, sir.
And thank you.